For you to use the price list, you just have to open orders and then click on price list. Then you can see all of your price list created. Here you can create price lists based on your suppliers or type of materials such as granite and quartz, or you can customize a price list, which can be alternative prices, or it can be a special price that you created to a customer. For you to create and add a new price list, you just have to click here in new. And then you can name your price list based on the type of price list you are creating. In this case, I will create one based on the supplier. You will have this blank space here, so it's where I can add my materials and then give them a price. The only thing that I have to do is click here and add prices. Then you can select the materials. Know that these materials listed here are not the same as your inventory. This is only the list of materials you have registered in the system. You also have the option to select all by clicking here. Notice that any of this information are mandatory, so you don't have to fill it in. You can choose if you're filling in or not. In this case, I'm going to choose the supplier, because I'm creating a supplier price list. I will choose the thickness of this material. So I know that whenever I'm selecting this price list, all of the materials will be the same thickness. And the same thing goes for quality and type of finish. This group is a customizable field where you can type it down whatever you want. So in this way you can group all of these materials into the same category. So what you can do is that you can type it down here a price, a special price. Or just like the size of these slabs, such as 78 by 78 like this. Here you can choose the type of price. So you can choose if you're charging by unit or square. And you can also define this price for each slab. Once you do that, you can hit save. And then you have all of the materials selected with the supplier name up in front. The material name, the thickness, quality, finish. And also the field that we typed the size of these slabs. Here you can see the type of charging, and you will be able to see the price. It is customizable. If you want to, you can change anything. You can delete and then just add here once again. Once you have created the price list, now you can use it. You can use your price list in many ways. The first case is where you can link your price list to a customer. So whenever you're creating an order to this customer, the price list will be automatically attached to the order. In this case, I'm going to add the price list we just created to the supplier one to this customer and hit save. So now whenever I create an order to the customer, the price list will come automatically. Just select the customer and then you will be able to see the price list. If you want to change, you just have to click here and select the price list you want. Now you are able to create a quote or an invoice. As you can see, the price list will be here, and now for you to use this price list, you just have to come here to custom and then select the type. The category here is slab. Then all of the materials you'll be seeing here are the same materials that you have inside the price list. So if I select here, the value will come automatically based on what you set on the price list. I can add as many materials as I want from the price list. And if I prefer to use a material from my inventory and not from the price list, I can switch here to all materials, and then I can customize a new price. So let's say in this case, I'm charging 800 and not 500 like the way it was in the price list. So I can use both items from my price list and items from my inventory inside this order. I can also use this price list inside the drawing. So if you can click here to add a drawing to this order. I will have the price list into the material section like this. If I click here and then select custom, I will be able to see the prices from my price list right here. If I want to add a picture, I just need to click here and add a picture that it won't interfere with the price for my price list. If I go back there to the quote, I will be able to see this item there. This second case is if you don't have a price list attached to the customer, you can simply come here and then select a price list for that customer in that specific order. You can select here and create the order as usual, and then you have the price list here and it works exactly the same way as it was shown. You also have the option to take a PDF from your price list in case if you want to handle to your customer. You just have to open the price list and click here in PDF, and then you will have a file which will be exactly the same information from the price list, with the material's name and price. And then you can handle to your customer so they can choose the material that they want to use. In case if you want to create a price list grouped into type of stone, you can do that, and then you can group the materials based on supplier. So basically what you can do is that you can type it down here, granite for example, and then save. Then you can add different types of materials from different suppliers. So in this case, the supplier will be this one. And then I can add once again another set of materials, but from a different supplier with a different pricing and characteristics. Like this. So I will have both suppliers here. So as you can see, I have this one and I have this one. Both with different pricing. And if I want to, I can group them based on the supplier or not. I just need to check this checkbox and it will work on the same way inside the PDF, so you can generate it and then give even more options to your customer. It will be like this. So you have both suppliers here. The price list can be used in many ways. So it's actually up to you. And if you have any questions, you can always reach us out.